you know, if I go like that, that's a lot of pain right throughout there. Just move my thumb if I try to.
Trying to bring your wrist up like that. You feel anything like that?
Up your arm. Oh, yeah. I feel like a stretch all the way up.
You feel a stretch in the back of your arm.
Yeah. And then I'm getting like weird. Like I just grabbed something the other day. Oh, I get it right there. Like real sharp pains, like stabbing pains in my fingertip now and again.
Just out of nowhere?
Yeah. Like I'll grab something and then feels like I get stung in the middle of my finger, but there's nothing that stung me. It just like.
How long did that?
Lasts for about like 30 seconds, 45 seconds. But it feels like I get stung by something.
When did you first notice it?
I guess it's happened to me before, but I really noticed it this. I paid attention to it when it hit this week. I noticed it.
And it's every time you grab something?
Not every time, but you know, even if I just push a lot of pressure, mm-hmm. do that, I can kind of feel it. And then sometimes, just out of nowhere, it feels like, you know, just putting pressure like that, feels like I get stung by a.
Just the right hand? Just the right
hand? I think it was. Yeah, like it doesn't last long, but I mean it's weird. It almost feels like you've been stung by a bee on your fingertip, like a big wasp.
Yeah.
And it's like a sharp pain right in your fingertip, and then it kind of goes away. But yeah, it's
okay.
Weird, but yeah, it's still super tight like throughout there.
Nerve stuff, nerve pains, weird world.
Yeah.
Go ahead, lay face down. Just see what's going on.
Back hasn't felt bad, but you always seem to make me notice it.
Right.
It always feels way better when I get done.
Adjusted up, and then we'll hit you with the spatula. It's like one of my patients called it.
The washa.
The washa tool. Yeah.
Washa.
Cracked me up when she called it a spatula. You worked all week last week.
Yeah.
Because of the concert.
Yep.
Sure.
Yeah. Fuck me.
Walk around in the sun. Looks like that's a lot of sun.
A little bit.
I mean.
What's that called that you're pushing on right there?
Right here?
Yeah, all through up there.
All through here?
Yeah, what is it?
Yeah, I mean, down here is...
It's like, not bone, but it's not...
Is that
just muscle or...
Yeah, so right here, like your last rib ends about right here.
Okay.
12th rib. So it goes... 12th rib's a partial rib, so it ends right here. So if you ever get... That right there, that's the end of your ribs. So
okay.
Real tender.
Yeah.
Your quadratus lumborum is kind of a squarish muscle that attaches all across your hip ridge, the ridge of your iliac crest right here.
Yeah.
to your spine to your lower rib. So it's kind of a big square muscle that kind of bends you from side to side and stabilizes your spine on top of your hips right there. And I mean, it's tight. It always gets tight on people. This is a cause for a lot of people's like low back discomfort for sure. And it attaches to your spine right here. So there's a bunch of different muscles that attach right there on your spine, honestly. But you asked me where I'm pressing over here. You said, it's not bone over there. It's a big space with a big muscle on it. So was it just the four of you at the show?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, I was hoping to do that. So I'm not into you guys, but after dinner, my mind just kind of went out.
That was my first instinct was to call you when I got out of there, but then my phone fell out of my hand.
What'd you say?
So my first instinct was to call you when I get out of there.
Oh, right, yeah.
But my phone flew out of my hand.
Oh. Oh, was that what happened? Was
yeah.
It a concert?
Oh, shit.
Huge fascial sheath right there, your thoracolumbar fascia. It's just whenever it gets all knotted up and stuff like that, it's just really, really hard to take the other way. That's why the wash up tool helps a lot. Yeah. love them because I'm going to touch your feet and then I'll come back up to your head. Okay. So I touch your head and then rub all over your face or whatever. Scoot yourself to this side of the table just a little bit. I got to adjust your feet and stuff. Adjust your back a little bit. Down, spin around. Well, face that wall. No, sit up. Sit up on it. There you go. Scoot forward a little bit. Your foot, your hands. Interlace your hands behind your head. Interlace your fingers, I mean. There you go. I'm going to lean you back. I'm going to get onto my knee here.
Oh,
nice. Okay, now go face down a little time. Check it out. You like that?
Mm-hmm.
How is that right there? It's a lot softer.
Yes, it feels a lot better.
Good. Still got some stuff right there. Got a nice deep breath in here. Thank you.
was a spot.
Yeah, I'm going to use your head to help us out here.
Straighten the bottom one?
Bottom one.
There you go.
Let's get your shoulder all the way back this way.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Let's
take a little bit of drops and see if we can get that thing moving.
Thank you.
Don't be in a hurry.
Yeah, no doubt. You want to feel me pick you up and just like bring you over to the right just a little bit because you're a little.
What's that?
You want to feel me pick you up? Your head's going to go to the right just because you're a little crooked on the table.
Okay.
Okay. There you go, just like that.
I feel like you go all the way down.
Yeah.
Need some adjustments right through there. Yeah. Clavicle first rib movement, stuff like that. Everything's so much smoother than like whenever we first started
good
like doing the gouache off a little bit. spatula.
Butter knife for people who've got stupid hands.
Say what?
Your butter knife for people who have stupid hands. Weakness of finger, like in my thumb or something.
Yeah, that was a good one. There you go. Does it feel that?
Yeah.
Just a little tiny click right there.
Ooh-wee.
Yeah, it makes that one a little tight too.
It's real easy, Ben. Just kind of stretch your arm down this way.
The nerve was right back there. Step.
You could. We haven't really addressed your this joint right here. There's a joint with your humerus and your radius right here.
Yeah.
I noticed the other one was pretty stuck. This one's probably worse.
That nerve, holy shit.
It's not even a nerve. You've just like all under here.
Oh. It feels like where your thumb's at is a nerve.
Yeah, it's just you've got a lot of inflammation right around this joint, and I mean it doesn't move. And this, honestly, this right here could cause your entire like thumb and forefinger issues.
Oh yeah, that's tender there.
Yeah.
Oh, it's right there.
Yeah, that's the joint line.
Yeah,
that's the joint line. There's a little like ball and cup joint right here. Yeah. Like this bone has this little indentation and kind of rests on the ball of this, and it rotates right there to allow this bone to kind of rotate around that bottom bone. This bone doesn't move. This bone moves around this bone, so you can turn your wrist like that. Still as sore.
Oh yeah.
There you go. If you can just relax right there, just give a tiny little couple little pushes here. See if that does anything as far as like kind of square you up on the spatula work. What's that feel like, worse?
No, I was doing that clicking like crazy.
Oh, is it? Well, at least it's getting some movement. There's, you know, there's.
I feel that there.
There's no real. There's, I don't know. Mm-hmm. But don't be afraid to go in there and just like work it out.
I do a lot,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, especially I'll take my knuckles and go over top like that and stuff like that.
That tool right there was probably like $11.
What, this washout?
Yeah, on Amazon?
Yeah, I was going to order one actually.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah, anything. I mean, butter knife probably would work, honestly, like the end of a butter knife. You all right? Doing okay?
Yeah. Feels really good.
Cool. Good.
A little crunchy when I do that. But it's like,
yeah. All that scar tissue breaking up and stuff like that in there. What'd you hear crunching around in there?
Oh, yeah.